Disruptors and curious minds, you're tuned in to the Thinking on Paper book club. I'm Mark, this is Jeremy, and we are on book number 7 of the book club. It's a new book. We're reading Irreducible by Federico Faggin, Consciousness, Life, Computers and Human Nature. And we're going deep. What is consciousness? And once we've wrestled with that, can machines be conscious? Is the AGI superintelligence rhetoric actually meaningless? We're going to find out. It's a heck of a book. Only in the last 100 years, with the advent of quantum physics, have we made great strides in understanding the nature of reality. We have in fact discovered that matter, which seems solid and compact, is instead made of vibratory energy. During the last 20 years, we have then understood that everything is made up of quantum information. However, there's still no theory capable of giving us a vision of the world that is consistent with both general relativity and quantum physics. In this book, I put forward the hypothesis that the universe has been conscious and had free will forever. What is it that makes us know? Does a robot know? And then he talks about Descartes, cogito ergo sum, I think, therefore I am. How do we know anything? What does it all mean for consciousness? What is consciousness? Jeremy, over to you.
Well, it's the knowing existing loop, right? To know is to exist is to be able to know is to know. Yeah, it's my head was spinning a little bit related to that. But as we get to some of his questions, I think they're super cool. Like there's one where we talk about the difference between a conscious entity or something natural versus something machine-like and created. So this was his reference between humans and machines, and he asked the question, have you ever seen a computer give birth to another computer with software and hardware? And in that discussion, he was comparing computers to living cells, because living cells, that's exactly what they do. They give birth to another version of the machine that is the cell. He puts this big thing, you see HAL 2000, you know, up on a hospital table, getting ready to give birth to HAL 2001, like...
Rather than me fumbling through what I think, I'm just going to read what he says.
I prefer your fumblings, Mark.
So, Descartes, cogito ergo sum, that is, I think, for therefore I am, isn't it? That's Descartes?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah.
I am so.
A machine, on the other hand, knows without knowing that it knows, and without even knowing what it means to know. Its knowing is unconscious and mechanical and cannot be called knowledge. It is simply information made up of meaningless symbols which can be mechanically linked to some other deterministic information or action. The robot's actions do not involve free and conscious choices made by the robot as an independent entity. And then he says, I should point out that we too have the same type of automatic behavior as robots in many situations. For example, when we drive a car, consciousness performs the function of supervisor of the mechanical processes of our body. That's, you know, you're driving, you don't know you're driving, suddenly you wake up and you're home. We don't wake up, but suddenly you're home. Ah, did I get home? I don't remember driving. Consciousness, yeah, it does not contribute to driving, however, unless it is necessary to intervene, in which case it takes over the conditional autonomy it granted to the body. It is the consciousness that understands the situation and therefore knows when to intervene. And this makes all the difference between a robot and a human being. In a robot, there is no conscious self-reflection, that it's independent of the algorithmic program and can thus change the decisions hardwired in the program. In a robot, there is no self and no self-witness. In a machine, there is no pause for reflection between symbols and action, because only within our consciousness can we find the meaning of symbols, a possible doubt and the free will to choose differently than the dictates of the mechanism. I think that what that means is, screw you, Yuval.
Oh my gosh. All right, so what did we just watch right there?
We watched Thinking on Paper, bite-sized, a shot of technological tequila to your prefrontal cortex. It's just a taster, a smorgasbord of what awaits you with the full Thinking on Paper interviews. There really is nothing like it out there at the moment, connecting the dots of all these technologies. So subscribe where you're listening, check the long former interviews out, and remember, stay curious.
Be disruptive.
Keep thinking on paper.